scored 50 points in the third quarter, thanks to James Harden, who scored 22 of his 36 in said quarter. Houston has a 3-1 lead over Minnesota now. Nick, how impressive was Houston last night?
It was the greatest offensive quarter of playoff basketball the league's seen in modern era. I mean, that's not even my opinion. That's just a fact. The only other team to score more than that was the 62 Lakers. This was the first time in a playoff game a team has beaten a team by at least 30 points in a quarter since the 86 Celtics, widely considered one of the five greatest teams ever. And they won because of their defense that quarter. They won 36-6.
Right.
The Rockets won 50-20. The score at halftime was 50-49.
One point!
They scored 50 points in the first half. That's amazing for an all-star game. I couldn't believe what I was seeing. It was just an unending avalanche of high-efficiency shots going in, and it came, CeCe, in their most important quarter of the season up to that point.
At that point, they were not shooting the ball well. It's one of the greatest displays of basketball I've seen in 12 minutes. There's a couple different talking points. You can either talk about James Harden outscoring the Timberwolves 22-20, or you can just talk about the rest of the team outscoring the Timberwolves, the 28 that they scored, if they were a four-man team. So it was remarkable. Also, Harden was hot, but he was still unselfish. It's hard to get 22 points and still be unselfish. I believe that they'll look back on this quarter and this be the quarter, because it's the best quarter that they've played in the four-game series. This will be the quarter that they went on their championship run.
Listen, the Rockets were the best team in the NBA all year long. And to be totally candid, through 14 quarters of playoff basketball, 3.5 games, they looked far from it.
Yes.
Through three games, the Pelicans looked better. The Warriors looked better. You could argue Philly looked better. The Rockets looked shaky even in their wins. And early in this game, James Harden starts out 0-7.
Yeah, P.J. Tucker goes down with a knee injury. I said, okay, here we go.
Right.
This begins the avalanche of injuries.
Absolutely. And Tucker's knee injury was a weird one. It looked really scary. And then he was back in the game 10 minutes later. Like, I thought he was done definitely for the game, maybe for the season. He ended up being – he's going – well, he came back, pardon me, so of course he'll be back. But what they did in the third quarter, I just want the audience to understand, when I say it's the most important quarter of their season, a one-point game at halftime. If they lose this game, it's a best of three for their season against an eight seed. And what would have been Chris Paul's a pending free agent. You would look at the head – all these things sound outrageous when you win 65 games. But if you win 65 games and you don't get out of the first round, and there are already questions about your coach, already questions about James Harden in the playoffs.
Don't forget the ghost of the past.
Right, already questions about Chris Paul. If they lose in the first round, everyone is thinking, okay.
Even if they go 6 or 7 games, that's like losing because they're underachievers in the playoffs. The coach said, oh, it wouldn't make a difference what we did in the playoffs after winning 65 games. So those things will begin, the pressure will begin to mount.
So that's what was on the line going into this quarter. It's the most pressure-packed quarter this version of these players, this year's team, has ever played together. The most important quarter you've played all year long. And you put a 50 ball on them, like there. Obviously scoring 50 in a quarter is wildly impressive, no matter what. But you do it in the second quarter of a game in a series. You're up 3-0. It's one thing.
Not when you've got a 1-point lead at halftime, knowing what the knock on you is, is that you succumb to the pressure in the playoffs that experiences the problem, and you put 50 points up, and both your stars score. They've had games where one scored, the other one scored. Chris Paul plays great, James Harden plays great, and you don't know if they can find a game where they both show up, and they both showed up. They put together a complete game and they play great.
And you got to keep your eyes on what else is going on in your conference. The Pelicans sitting at home chilling. They didn't already swept Portland. Golden State getting ready to get the gentleman sweep in with the Spurs. Like, you need to keep an eye, because it's not what this series would do. It's the next round, the totality of round number 3, and then ultimately a month from now when you're in the NBA Finals. So it was important to get that commanding 3-1 lead.
And the other part of it is, and we alluded to it with the P.J. Tucker near injury or near serious injury, is luck matters on this. And Luke Richard-Mbeumute earlier this season dislocated his shoulder and missed a month plus. At the very end of the regular season, I think it was game 81, might have been game 82, he looked like he did the same thing. And it's like, oh, well, he's going to be out for at least the first two rounds of the playoffs. He gave some quotes saying, not nearly as bad as the previous one. I think I'm going to be back around round two. PJ, so there's a dodged bullet, one dodged bullet. PJ Tucker was helped their defensive identity. Mm-hmm. It looked like he blew out his knee. He's back on the court 10 minutes later. There's another dodged bullet. There is not a team in the playoffs on either side of the bracket aside from Philly that is as healthy as Houston right now. So it's not surprising. Those are the two teams right now you probably feel the best
about. We're worrying about George Hill missing game number four in Indianapolis. He catches a pick a couple games ago, just running down the court. Now he's got back spasms. So you're right. Every time you go out there, the probability of getting hurt and Lady Luck not being on your side, the risks go up.
I love when Lady Luck is on my side. She's been amazing. Coming up, could Lamar Jackson be the heir apparent to Tom Brady? Lamar Jackson, next on First Things First.
Say, I love a lady.
No, so no.
I love a lady.